Welcome to this evening's edition of E Prime. I'm Kalia. Christopher Martin debuts on top. Christopher Martin's new sophomore album And Then has topped the Billboard reggae album charts, featuring the singer's trademark sugar reggae flavor. And Then songs cover a wide range of feelings and emotions and feature top-notch producers including Robert Livingston, Lamar Riff Raff Brown, King Yard Production, White God Productions, and Chimney Records. The 15-song set released earlier this month by VP Records is the follow-up to his I'm a Big Deal album released in 2017, which reached number 3 on the Billboard Reggae Album Charts. Meanwhile, reggae icon Rita Marley has scored a Billboard entry. Her latest album, The Best of Rita Marley, Lioness on the Rise, currently sits at number 3 on the Billboard Reggae Charts. The chart entry is noteworthy as it marks the first time the singer has entered the Billboard Reggae Charts since her music legacy started in 1966. The Tuff Gong Worldwide project released on May 3rd features 10 hit tracks such as One Draw, Thank You Ja, and Who Feels It. Throughout her music career, the former iTrees member has entered the Billboard charts 2 other times. In 1982, her track One Draw was number 48 on Billboard's disco chart, and in 1991, her album We Must Carry On was number 5 on the World Albums chart. Reggae Sumfest Awards Get Social. The Sumfest Get Social Awards, slated for next month, aims to recognize and pay tribute to the best of Jamaican Caribbean influences, companies, and organizations on social media. The award show also intends to highlight the impact social media has on shaping and pushing the culture forward, influencing social change and helping to flourish the world of entertainment. Categories include awards for male artist reggae, female artist reggae, male artist dancehall, female artist dancehall, best comeback song of 2018, dance song of 2018, best producer, best DJ, and icons of the stage. In news overseas, Rihanna breaking fashion barriers. The Bajan pop princess has created fashion history by being the first woman to join the LVMH Moet Hennessy Louis Vuitton fashion house for her own fashion brand. The 31-year-old singer is also the first woman of color to have a label at the top of an LVMH Maison and the first woman to start an original brand for the world's largest luxury group. The new label is named Fenty after the last name of the singer, born robbing Rihanna Fenty, and is an expansion of her cosmetics empire of the same name, launched in a 2017 partnership with LVMH. The Paris-based fashion line, which is developed by Rihanna and takes shape with her vision, will include ready-to-wear clothing, leather goods, shoes, and accessories, and will launch this spring 2019 season. In a post on social media, Rihanna asserts the deal is good for the culture and thanked the chief executive of LVMH, Bernard Arnault, for giving her the opportunity to grow with LVMH to develop a fashion house in the luxury sector with no artistic limits. Rihanna's Fenty line, which is the first new house established by the LVMH group since Christian Lacroix in 1987, will join legacy brands like Dior, Givenchy, and Fendi. That's it for this evening's edition of E Prime. I'm Kalia. Thanks for watching.